So thank you, Aiden. See you later, buddy. Hey everybody, Ethan here with Standing Stone, and we've got a really fun video for you today. If you watched the last video with Thunder, we started working on his healing, and I had explained that he really hasn't done a whole lot. But one thing that I have noticed, and it's a question that we get pretty regularly, is how do I teach my dog to greet people properly while I am on a walk? And I mentioned in that last video, so you need to go back and watch that one, but I mentioned we don't have the opportunity to have places to go walk where we actually meet people. So we've taken this today to go to town to our friend's house and take Thunder for a walk and then show how we can interact with meeting people along that and then how to help him to actually greet those people properly. There's gonna be two big things that we have to do and we're gonna share those with you today. To get started, I want to set him up. We've got our easy lead. That's what I was showing he is working on. We're gonna run this around here. We're gonna make one flip down here and we're set up. That's how easy it is. It's clipped to his collar in case anything were to actually happen, but we have our head halter style leash. Now, a big thing that I hear from people and the way that it's explained to us a lot is we go for a walk for exercise. Well, I want to explain to you or try and explain to you that the walk itself for these athletic breed dogs is not physical exercise. I mean, at best, it's, you know, a borderline usage of even the amount of athleticism that's in one toe. I mean, they aren't really doing anything from a physical standpoint. What they are doing, though, is all mental based. They're looking, they're smelling, they're seeing, they're having to focus on you. And the mental aspect of things doesn't change if you walk 2 miles or if you do, you know, just up and down the street or even in your own driveway. Now, we did another drill called the 10-yard healing drill. If you haven't seen that video, go check it out. But we essentially utilized 10 yards of space to work on some manners. So I'm gonna start by warming him up that way. We're just doing like I would do with my dog as a healing session, even though we are in town where the majority of y'all live. So heel, good. We're going to keep him by our side. We can utilize little things, like right now he was trying to jump up on the curb. We can use that as a barrier. Anything in your surrounding here, you can help to teach the dog how to do a better job of focusing on you. Come on. And staying where he's supposed to. So in that 10-yard healing drill, we essentially tried to walk the distance of 10 yards. We utilized lines on the concrete as markers to stop at. So we've got several here on the driveway. Good, we're starting here, we're gonna ask heel. And then stop. Good boy, heel. Good. Tugging on the lead means to stop. So make sure you're not putting a big emphasis on tugging on the lead to get your dog started. Pulling should mean stop. If you're going to, one pop is okay, but the key being here, and you can see that relax most likely, that relax on the leash itself says to him that, you know, it's okay to walk at this point. Later, we're going to stop you by pulling on this. Make sure you don't have constant tension. We see that as a big mistake that people are making. They're trying to walk their dog and the dog is feeling uncomfortable. You can see he's feeling uncomfortable and that is sending mixed signals. You're asking him to move and stop at the same time. So on and off, pressure on, pressure off. Good. So in this drill, come on. I'm utilizing these lines for him and myself, more for me, but heel. And we stop at each one. Good. That lets me know he's paying attention. Good. And allows me to be honest with myself. Did he stop when I asked him to or did he creep on? On that last one, he tried to creep on. It took a couple extra little pops. Okay? So these are all extremely good things. Now, the differences here too is I can see it out of him. He is seeing different stuff that's going on. There's vehicles drove by, there's sprinklers going on down the road. He's seeing all of those things as distractions and all of this is continuing to work that mental aspect of things. Now today we have an unseasonably warm, well, I don't know how unseasonably warm it is, but it's warmer than what we've been dealing with. So in the upper 70s, he's already starting to feel a little bit warm, and it's just because he's not conditioned to that temperature yet. But now we're gonna get some friends. This is the big thing that I was talking about, how to teach your dog to greet people properly and have good manners on lead. Now there are two big problems with this. One, first of all, and first and foremost, is the conditioning that's already come into play. Okay, from little puppy on, every time that puppy meets somebody new, you have your friends over or you go someplace with them, everybody's like so excited to see the puppy, and they get down on their level and the puppy jumps up on them and they rub their head and their belly, and it's a big thing, right? When you do that, you're essentially conditioning that response. The puppy knows for the first 2 to 3 years of its, 2 to 3 months of its life, that when I meet new people, the way that I interact with them is by jumping on them and acting like a fool, okay? Then they get big. And when they get to this size, that jumping around and naughty behavior is not as enjoyable. And then we're all trying to figure out why they're doing this and how to stop it, okay? So now that we've understood where the behavior comes from, we're gonna talk about two things that need to happen in order to fix it. Number one is we need to manage the dog's behavior, and they need to understand that they don't get to greet every single person they see. As soon as we can establish that in their brain, it's going to be a lot easier. They're not going to be pulling you to meet that person because they know it's exciting and fun. They're going to, in fact, know that they don't get to do that with enough time and conditioning. Now again, remember, it took months to get to this point. It's going to take similar amounts of time to get to a different point. The better point, the conditioning that is the behavior that we want to see out of the dog. Now the next thing, that's number two of the most important things, is you're going to have to manage the people. That's kids, adults, whoever. You've got to say, hey, we're trying to develop a puppy here that has good manners and is respectful when it meets new people. So we need to make sure that he is behaving himself before you come up and greet him, okay? So I'm going to take just a second, I'm going to get some help, and I'm gonna show you his natural reaction to walking up, greeting new people on a walk, and then how we work through that. All right guys, so we've got Lindsay, and Aiden is helping us out today to be high levels of distraction, as well as get a smile and wave. So we're gonna show what his interaction is just on just on meeting people, and then from there we'll show how to work through it. All right, Aiden, I need you to hold Lindsay's hand, and you're gonna come up and greet Thunder, okay? Do it. See this right here? Okay, Thunder is excited to meet people. He's excited about the energy that the little boy brings, and he's got the easy lead on still, so he's still under control, but he's interested in that. He's excited about that. You see the little tail vibrating. This stuff is fun, okay? So instead, now this time, all right, A, go ahead and hold Lindsay's hand. All right, so I'm gonna walk down here and then we're gonna meet just right up in here if you guys are walking toward us. Come on, Thunder, good boy. Good, okay. So now, you see already he's trying to pull to go that direction. Now we can greet here, and what I'm gonna ask Thunder to do, sit, hey, sit. Thunder, sit. No, sir, sit. You're just doing it so nicely while we were waiting. Come on. Thunder, sit. Good boy, right there. So we're gonna ask him to sit and stay, and then allow some of that energy to diminish, basically. It's not an instantly exciting thing, even though there is high energy of a little boy right there, okay? Now that Thunder is being well-behaved, he's sitting, he's calming, Aiden, will you come up here and pet Thunder? Now, there's one rule, okay? Listen first. If he jumps up or tries to get, see, already he's starting to get more amped, we need to take time, okay? If he tries to get up and move, I'm going to back away and you're gonna back away. But if he sits and behaves like this, you can pet him on the head, really nice. See? He tried to get up and be exciting. Sit down now. Hey, sit down. Good. So we're gonna wait and pet him nice. Good job. Yes. Good job. So children, especially, are gonna want to come and see the puppy. It's a lot of fun. They wanna come pet the dogs. Dogs are awesome. And helping to teach proper interactions with the people that wanna come up and pet your dogs is important. Hey, come this way. The other side of it is, we need to teach him that he doesn't get to greet everyone, okay? So thank you, Aiden. See you later, buddy. We need to teach Thunder that he doesn't get to greet every single person that he interacts with. If you apply these two specific things, that one being that he sits and waits and doesn't get to greet everybody, and then the second being when he does get to greet and interact with people, we make sure and take the time for him to be sitting, staying, behaving before that greeting happens. Those two things are gonna develop the good behavior that we can greet people properly on a walk. Good job, buddy. Guys, that is all there is for this tip. I'm the guy with the pink gun. This is Thunder. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.